evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Message from the Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly of Western Armenia, Lidia Margossyan. The statement by the MP of Western Armenia, Karapet Topuzyan. Support for Artsakh. Attends back sanctions to those involved in Turkey's drilling operations in Cyprus. Most of the enemy's victims were representatives of the national minorities living in Azerbaijan, Vahram Poghosyan. Gold reserves were discovered in one of the cities of Western Armenia. Creative Armenia announces Artists for Artsakh Fund. Following the unilateral attacks carried out by the Republic of Azerbaijan on September 27, 2020, against the Armenian civilian population of the Autonomous Republic of Artsakh, the deputies of the National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia gathered today in a plenary session mandated me to transfer to all the parliaments of the world, to the media, as well as to the general public our strong condemnation of the attacks of Azerbaijan against the Armenian national territory of Artsakh. The National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia also calls on the international community and the Minsk group in particular to condemn the aggression of Azerbaijan in violation of the international law and to participate in stopping these criminal attacks against the Armenian civilian population through diplomatic channels for the restoration of order and an immediate ceasefire. The National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia denounces that the attacks were planned by Azerbaijan with the explicit support of Turkey. Therefore, Azerbaijan as an executor of acts of war and Turkey as accomplice and instigator will be held responsible for all human losses as well as material and moral damages. The respect that your media outlet has gained over the years and its firm commitment to just causes gives us confidence to ask you to disseminate this parliamentary call so that humanity does not remain indifferent to this crime in the spirit of world peace. Karapet Topuzyan, a member of the Parliament of Western Armenia, informs, Garnik Sarkisyan used my name to form his own organization without my consent. He condemns Garnik Sarkisyan's move and demands that he no longer use his name illegally. Dear compatriots, Western Armenia together with the Armenians all over the world calls on to help our compatriots in Artsakh. To do this, we ask for your financial support. You can make transfers either to the Ministry of Finance of the Artsakh Republic or to the Insurance Foundation for Servicemen. Thus, your help will be used in the most effective way. Bank account details are provided on our website. Attends supports Nicosia in imposing sanctions on the European Union summit, which opens on Thursday, against those involved in Turkey's drilling in the Mediterranean Sea, which violates the borders of the exclusive economic zone on the Republic of Cyprus. The statement came from the Greek Foreign Minister Nikos Dendias after a meeting with his Cypriot counterpart Nikos Christodoulidis in Nicosia, TASS reports. Dendias said Greece is still ready to consider imposing financial sanctions on Turkey. He also accused Ankara of illegal activities in the Caucasus, Libya, Iraq, and Cyprus. Earlier, Christodoulidis met with the Spanish foreign minister, during which the issue of anti-Turkish sanctions was also raised. Most of the enemy's victims were representatives of the national minorities living in Azerbaijan. Vahram Poghosyan, head of the Central Information Department of the Office of President of the Republic of Artsakh, stated this during the briefing at Artsakh Information Headquarters. According to him, only 148 Lezgin soldiers were killed in one direction. There are several casualties among Talishan soldiers, which has caused serious resentment among national minorities living in Azerbaijan. In the near future, we will probably witness the protest actions of the representatives of those nations because these facts prove once again that Azerbaijan uses such provocative actions to show such behavior towards the national minorities living in its country, Poghosyan said. The spokesman of the president of Artsakh noted that such policy was once implemented towards the Armenians of Artsakh, particularly during the Soviet period, when Artsakh was part of Azerbaijan. Gold reserves of 8 million cubic meters have been discovered in the Erzurum province of Western Armenia. It is known that gold is 4 grams per ton of reserves. In the village of Boğazgören, with 120 inhabitants and 60 households, businessmen received the right to extract gold in an area of 1,500 hectares. Thousands of people will have the opportunity to work in the gold mines. According to preliminary data, the annual value added of the gold mine will be $400 million. Artists for Artsakh is a creative fund for filmmakers, photographers, writers and artists who are creating works that bring attention to Artsakh and its people, whether in Artsakh or working beyond its borders to capture the truth and raise awareness. Artists can apply for Artists for Artsakh grants to support their projects. It is for films, photographs, literature, music and art that the world will understand what is happening in Artsakh, said Garin Hovhannisyan, founding director of Creative Armenia. Now let us represent your attention a song by Sahak Sahakyan. You can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.